All right, guys, what we're doing today here is I recently got a lot of variety of paint sent to me from a friend. Can you see, I shot a video of the paint rack recently, since it's gotten all set up. But a lot of these brands I've never used. This Ammo by Meg, this AK's third generation, this Mission Paints. These are E7s. They're supposed to be copies of direct ripoff, you could say, of the Gaia Notes, which I do like. I do like lacquer paints. I've been using Mr. Color for a while. They're my favorites, but I've heard some of these acrylics have gotten way better than the early acrylics. I don't like Vallejo. I have some Vallejo, only a handful. Mecca colors up there, and the varnish, which is good. These turbo dorks I haven't tried yet. These are all color shifting, and that's the MIGs, that's the AKs, and I haven't tried ever once these acrysian. This is the Mr. Hobby acrylics, and this is their other acrylic, but this is more in the line of like Tamiya's acrylics, a solvent based acrylic. These are pure water based, so we will try that too. I'm just waiting for the red. The red hasn't come in yet. This is metallic red. I want to do all reds. My experiment is I'm going to do all of them to see how they compare, but comparing the same color, at least similar. Like, I'm going to shoot all reds. So we're going to try all of these paints in a similar color. I'm going to spray everything on a spoon. I prime the spoon white. I like white primer for my reds. And that's it. What we're going to do is we're going to mix everything, airbrush it at the booth, and then we'll come back. I won't speak. I'll probably play some background music while I'm airbrushing, mixing, so you guys can see. A couple of things. We'll start with Mission. Here's Mission. It's just plain old red Mission paints. They come with a marble. They're larger size, so they're of a little more value, I guess. These are $2-3 a bottle. Yeah, I think these are closer to $5. Here is a paint mixer that just came in. This is basically, I think they call this nail polish stirrer, but it will mix paint. There we go. And it's plug-in, so no battery waste. All right, what I'm going to do is I'm going to lock in the camera here over the bench. Let's see if I can get that without jarring you guys too much. Let's see. That's not too bad. Let's get over the bench more. That's pretty good. All right. One more tip. Get yourself some rags. These are small terry cloth face cloths. Actually, they're bigger. These are more like kitchen towels, hand towels. I got a bunch in a little rag bin, but I use them. I can get pretty much probably two models done with just one of these, even not more. You lay it down whenever you're going to paint. Keep all of your stuff on here. I've spilt so many times and ruined my base that I started putting on paper towel, which is also a waste. Let's grab a piece now. But now when I mix over this, it just lands on this. Matter of fact, even when I'm done stirring, which you'll see now, you can just wipe on here, you know? Or if you wipe it on your cloth, put the cloth down, that messes up nothing. Everything stays on this cloth, and when you're done, when you go to stop building your Gundam or your car kit, you peel this back and just work on the bench. But when you're doing anything mixing paints, go here. Now, Model Mission calls for, they recommend, this polyurethane additive. You know, 10 to 20% of this, and the thinner if you want it. They say, sounds pretty thin. It says you can shoot it out the bottle. We're going to try it straight out of the bottle. We're going to go by each of their recommendations. So we'll start straight out of the bottle, but I will add the polyurethane, which is more of a leveler and a retarder. So we like both. And a flow improver. I think it does it all. So we'll give that a try. We'll leave this here in case I got to clean the gun with it. We're going to shoot it with a single action Mr. Hobby. It's already ready to go. Single action because I'm just going to throw this on quick. There's no need for any kind of control. And that's it. So what I'm going to do is we're going to mix these things up, and then we're going to shoot them. And then when I'm done, I'm going to shoot each color. I'll show each mixing, and we'll go over to it And when we're done, I'll come back, I'll turn on, we'll lay all the spoons out, and we'll see how these all work. All right? We'll see you at the end of this. Alright guys, let me turn off the spray booth here. One second. Hard to get at. Get my glasses. Alright. Here's the results. I got these lined up. Right here. So, there's the E7 lacquer. The AK. Intense colors. Mission models. The MIG, ammo by MIG, and my traditional personal favorite, the Mr. Color lacquer. This Korean lacquer, this E7, came out a little rough, but a lot of lacquers have to be buffed and gloss coated. Not all of them behave like Mr. Color, I'm not quite sure why, but this is how traditional lacquers behave. But it did go on good. The Intense AK sprayed good. It's a matte. These are mostly mattes. I'm not sure why this came out gloss. We'll go through that in a second. But it was even. It sprayed good. It went on good. It dried quick. The Mission sprayed the best. Other than my lacquer, which I prefer. As far as an acrylic goes, that Mission models, it came out even, perfect. Smooth surface. It's tough. The scratch. It just came out terrific. So as far as the acrylics go, this one followed by this. Now this is the only one that sprayed gloss. I accidentally bumped it. That's the little mark there when I was putting it down. But not the best texture. But you know, you do got a matte coat, and I do gloss coat my stuff anyway. But it's a true red versus these other two. And it came out gloss. So different characteristic, but still sprayed pretty good. Not as good as this. And the Mr. Color Red Matter number 68, it just what can I say, nothing beats this stuff. You got to put leveling thinner to get the best result, which is what I did. I've been using it consistently. That's the way I would go, but that's me. It's my personally, but these Mission paints, which are right here, are fantastic. So well, the one test so far, I still got to test these brand new Humbrol acrylics. That'll be next. And then I got a couple of these. This is my Subaru Blue for my next kit. So I do have a few more to test. But I did want to try these acrylics against these lacquers. And that's the results. So there you have it. When I test the others, the Humbrol and the SMS and the other lacquers, I'll go through them. And I have, I think there's some new Aquios coming in from Mr. Color. So we'll see how their high-level acrylics, mostly like Tamiya, but that's what they say. Anyway, guys, that's the test. I recommend, as far as acrylic goes, acrylic, these Mission models are great, followed by these brand-new AK third gens. And above all else, I always start with my Mr. Hobby lacquers. A couple of kits came in today. My Grim Grid, which I've been waiting for a while, and this is my first Zoid. So maybe we'll do an unboxing of those. All right, guys, you have it going, and we'll talk to you soon.